Let's face it, unless it cancels our outdoor plans or is unusually severe, rain washes off our lives and runs out of our minds. Rain that falls on land simply soaks into the ground or runs downhill and flows into a creek, river, lake, or the ocean. Rain, rain, go away.
In a forested setting, when it rains, you have a lot of infiltration into the ground, and you don't have as much water that actually gets into the stream. But in an urban setting, when we have all this impervious surface cover, when that water hits the pavement, that water's not infiltrating into the ground, and that impervious surface acts as pathways for pollutants to get into our waterways through our stormwater system.
But rain that takes a shortcut through a storm drain goes straight into the nearest body of water. The bad news is that water picks up chemicals from the road and fertilizers and animal waste from yards. The water isn't filtered by the ground. It also doesn't get treated in a water treatment plant.
This is a very urban system right here. I mean, we are in downtown Durham.
That's why Maverick Raber is climbing around the South Ellerby Creek tributary. The storm water that enters this tributary goes right into Ellerby Creek, then into Falls Lake, which supplies drinking water for Durham and Raleigh. The lake eventually drains into the Neuse River, then into the Albemarle-Pamlico Sound, and then into the ocean. Pollution here is pretty far-reaching. Raber is working on a pilot project studying a new solution to the pollution caused by stormwater runoff.
It's not what we would consider pristine water, but we're trying to figure out, you know, what's in this water and where's it coming from. And then part of this project is how can we reduce the impacts of being in an urban setting.
The land that drains into Ellerby Creek and its tributaries is called a watershed. Ellerby Creek's watershed has the highest population density in Durham because it runs through the city, close to downtown. That's why the city of Durham has set up 5 monitoring sites like these at key points along the creek.
What we can do with this is we can set it up and program it to collect samples throughout a storm.
The sensor in the pipe detects when the water level is rising, which signals the start of a storm.
We collect 6 liters on the rising limb of a storm. We try and capture near the peak, and then again on the falling limb of the storm. So we're trying to characterize the water quality throughout that hydrograph.
But it's what the city is installing around the South Ellerby Creek tributary that is so important.
So in this rain garden, we're capturing runoff coming down from the driveway and also coming from 2 of our downspouts.
109 residents agreed to participate in a project to reduce the runoff into the creek. So the city is installing rain gardens, like these, in the yards of some houses. Rain gardens are shallow depressions about 1 foot deep. They have a berm to stop the runoff, and they're lined with topsoil and mulch and planted with native plants that absorb runoff.
When you're capturing it in the rain garden and letting it soak in, you're keeping that runoff from entering the drainage system. That helps our water quality by reducing the storm surge that rushes to our creeks during and right after a rainstorm. Our lawns soak in some of the runoff, but grass roots are only about that deep. And our soil here is very clay rich and pretty compacted. So a lot of the water just still rushes off in a storm and enters the storm drainage system if it's just flowing over the lawn. With a rain garden, you're able to really capture that water and let it slowly soak in.
Other homes are having cisterns like this attached to downspouts. The gardens and the cisterns are being installed for free. The locations were chosen for having the greatest potential to reduce runoff. The city wants to see if you cluster significant groups of rain catchers and businesses and houses using cisterns or rain gardens, you can have a significant impact on what goes into a stream, not only what goes in, but how fast it goes into a stream. And communities across the state are looking at this 5-year program to see what they find out. 2 rain gardens are being installed in a main drainage point along Onslow Street near Duke's East Campus. 1 garden is going into Paul Sapp's backyard. Sapp says there's always standing water on the sidewalk and the street in front of his house, water that flows into the creek down the street.
My father grew up on a farm himself, and so he sort of understands the importance of letting the water run into the land and not letting it all run off into the sewers, making its way out into the ocean, carrying all of the nutrients and potential pollutants that it could have, but letting it settle out in the land itself.
The mantra is slow it down, spread it out, soak it in. Because if you are doing that with your stormwater, then you are greatly reducing the amount of polluted runoff that's going to rush to the creek during a storm. If you cluster a lot of these practices in one area, which is what we're trying to do with rain catchers, then you maybe start to see some real effect in the stream in terms of filtering out some of those pollutants before they hit the stream and also reducing the volume of water that's rushing to the creek in a storm.
Comparing the water quality readings from the monitoring stations along the South Ellerbe Creek tributary, where all the rain catchers are clustered, with readings from stations along the creek itself should provide the answer.
Are we impacting the water quality and the hydrology in Ellerbe Creek? And that's an ongoing study, and hopefully we'll get some answers to that.